So the way the project, this project came about was, it's been a long time in the works. It was something that I actually dreamed about a long time ago. I have these sketchbooks that are just full of ideas that are someday ideas, and someday when I have the budget, or someday when I have the space and the time. And this one was one of those really far in the future someday projects. Really excited to see it come together because this partnership with Jen and with Wiley was really serendipitous. I met the team the first day here at Soma Arts when Wiley and Jen came to visit the space and to talk about the idea. We immediately fell into the sequence of just laughing about the project and how we were going to get it done and finishing each other's sentences for how we were going to mount the projectors and how the animations were going to get created. And Jen had wonderful ideas about how to practically do the performance and how she envisioned it and how she envisioned dancing as well, which immediately put her in the front running spot. There is a kind of Pygmalion-like statue figure that is kind of coming to life to music and is rising as the music starts to kind of become conscious of its own body, its arms, its legs, its fingers, but is somewhat dissatisfied with the prison area that's completely devoid of color. And there's a storm that passes over that starts to illuminate the character and charge the character with anima. And as the performance progresses and the music progresses, the performer begins to express themselves through dance more aggressively with longer movements, motions, and poses. Is this statue kind of coming to life for a brief moment, taking all of that in for the first time, becoming overwhelmed by it, and then returning to this inert state?